Hello students, hope you all are good. Today we are going to start our chapter number 3, that is playing with number. So let's start with this introduction. The first two terms which you are going to learn in this chapter, that are factors and multiple. So a factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Means whenever you're going to divide a given number, then the factor exactly divides that number, means leaving the remainder zero. Now the second, that is multiple. A number is said to be a multiple of any of its factor. Means when you're going to multiply a factor with any number, then your product is always the multiple. So let's take an example. If I am having a number 6 into 4, then when you're going to multiply 6 with your 4, then your result is 24. So when you're going to multiply two number, your product that you get, that is multiple. That is multiple. And the number which two numbers which are going to be multiplied, that are called factors. So these 6 and 4 are factors. Okay, so we can say that 6 and 4 are factors of 24, or you can say the multiple of 6 is 24, multiple of 6 4 is 24. Means when you're going to multiply 6 with 4, you get a number 24, that is the multiple of 6. So now taken another example, if I'm going to multiply 8 by 3, then your multiple is also 24. It means your multiple is same in this case and factors are different. So it means 24 is having two more factors, that is 8 and 3. So 8 is also factor of 24 and 3 is also factor of 24. So we are having some more factors also. When you're going to divide 24 by 12, so obviously it goes on 2 and 24 and your remainder is 0. So what you will get over here, when you are going to multiply 12 by 2, then also your answer is 24. It means again your multiple is same, that is 24, 24. But this time factors are again different, that is 12 and 2. So from this victory can conclude 12 is 24's factors are 6, 4, 8, 3, 12, 2. These are the factors of 24. So not these. There are two main factors of every number which we can get. That is 1. So we can easily divide 24 by 1. So 1 is also the factor of 24. And 24. When you are going to divide number 24, then it is also completely divisible. So these are also the factor of 24. Or you can say when you are going to multiply 1 by 24, then also your result is 24. So till now, how much factors of 24 we get? That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 24. So from here we conclude that these are the factors of number 24. Means when you are going to multiply, so you will get this multiple by these factors. So this is how you can find out the factors and multiples of the given numbers. Means the multiplicands are your factors and your product is always your multiple. So after factor and multiples, next topic is type of natural number. So first is even number. Even number means a number exactly divisible by 2, or we can say multiple of number 2. So for identifying even numbers, we generally having a simple things to remember, simple digits to remember, that is if a number contains 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 as its ones place. At its ones place, then the number is called even number. Okay, so by if I am saying if a number is having 416, so we can clearly see that its ones place is 6. It means 416 is an even number. So if any of these digits is at ones place, that number is even number. Now the second is, that is odd number. A number which is not exactly divisible by 2, or we can say which is not the multiple of 2. So for identifying odd numbers, we are having 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 at ones place. If these digits are at ones place of any number, that number is called to be odd number. That number is called to be a odd number. For example, 527. So we can say the, see this 7 is at ones place. So we can see that 527 is a odd number. After that, we're having some properties of even and odd number. Let's do this properties. If this is a type of number, operation we are going to apply and then the result. If I'm taking an even number and I'm adding 1 or subtracting 1 into it, then our result is an odd number. How? Let's find out this answer by an example. By an example. So, for example, if I am having 8, an even number, and I am going to subtract 1 from it. So, what I am going to get? 7. And if I am going to add 1 into it, what am I going to get? It's 9. 7 and 9 both are odd numbers. So, whenever you are going to add 1 or subtract 1 from an even number, your result is always a odd number. Now the second one, even number, addition with even number. Means when you're going to add two even number, your answer is always an even number. For example, 4 is an even number, 6 is an even number. When you're going to add them, you get 10. 10 is also an even number. So addition of an even number with even number, result is an even number. Now the third one, even number, addition with odd number. Means when you're going to add an even number with an odd number, your answer is an odd number. For example, if I'm having 8 is an even number and 3 is an odd number. When you're going to add it, you will get 11. So, 11 is an odd number. So, addition of even number with odd number result in odd number. Now, the next one, when you're going to multiply an even number with an even number, your result is an even number. So, let's do it. I'm having 6 as an even number, multiplication with an even number, that is 4, and your answer is 24. That is also an even number. So when you are going to multiply any number, any even number with other even number, result is a even number. Now the next, even number multiply with the odd number. So I am having 6 again as an even number and 3 as an odd number. So what you will get? 18. So this is also a even number. Means when you are going to multiply even number with odd number, your answer is a even number. So from last two, we can conclude that whenever you are going to multiply any number that is odd or even with the even number, your result is always even number. Now next, odd numbers. So whenever you're having odd number and you're going to add or subtract one from it, your answer is an even number. For example, 7 is an odd number, you're going to add 1 into it, you will get 8, and when going to subtract 1 from it, you will get 6. So both are even number. Means subtraction or addition of 1 from an odd number result into a even number. Now the next one, addition with odd number. It means when you're going to add a odd number into another odd number, so your result is a even number. 3 is a odd number, 7 is a odd number, and your result 10, that is even number. You can say that sum of two odd number is always a even number. Sum of two odd number is always a even number. Now the next one, odd number, addition with even number. Means when you're going to add an odd number into an even number, your answer is 9, that is an odd number. So, odd number plus even number, answer is an odd number. Okay, now the next one, odd number, multiply with an odd number. So, when you're going to multiply an odd number with another odd number, for example, 7 into 5, both are odd number, and your answer is 35. So, 35 is an odd number. So, product of two odd number is always an odd number. Now, odd number multiply with even number. Means when you're going to multiply odd number with even number, your result is an even number, which we already done in even number also. So, let's do an example related to it. Odd number, let's take it 9 as an odd number. And when you're going to multiply it with an even number, so you will get 18. So, 18 is an even number. So, multiplication of an odd number with an even number result into even number. Now, let's move to the another type of natural number. Now, next type of natural number is prime number. So, prime number is a number which is exactly divisible by two factors, that is 1 and itself is called prime number. Or you can say prime numbers are those numbers which are having only two factors. And the two factors is 1 and the number itself. For example, if I am having 5 as a number and if I am going to find its factor, you can say that 5 is only divisible by 1 and 5 only. Or you can say 5 is 1 into 5. So, there are only two factors of 5, that is 1 and 5. So, we can say 5 is a prime number. Similarly, if I am having 17, then 17 will not come in table of any of the numbers. So, 17 is having factor 1 and 17, 1 into 17. So, 17 is also a prime number. Okay. Now, the next number is composite number. Now, a number having more than two factors are known as composite numbers. Or you can say number except prime numbers are called prime numbers. Composite numbers. Number except prime numbers are called composite number. For example, 24. So, 24 is having 2, 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. So it's having more than two factors. So this number 24 is called composite number, or you can say 8. So 8 is having 1, 2, 4. So 8 is also a composite number. Okay, 9. 9 is 1, 3, and 9. These are the factors of 9. So 9 is also a composite number. Now the next is co-prime number. Two natural numbers having no common factor other than 1. Means if two natural numbers is not having, if you are going to find out their factor and then compare, then only 1 is the common factor. So let's find out the number. For example, if I am having 8 and 9, which we have already taken over here. So 1 is also a common factor over here, 1 is also a common factor here. So we can say 8 and 9 are co-prime numbers. Or you can also say that two consecutive natural numbers are also always co-prime numbers. Now the sixth one, twin prime numbers. A pair of prime numbers whose difference is 2. Means when you're going to subtract two prime numbers, then their difference is always 2, then those two prime numbers are said to be called twin prime. For example, 5 and 3. When you're going to minus them, you get 2 as the difference. So 5 and 3 are twin prime number. Or you can say 13 and 11. When you're going to minus 11 from 13, you get 2 as the difference. So 13 and 11 are prime number. Or you can say it's 7 minus 5. Then your answer is also 2. So these are also twin prime numbers. So the two pair of two prime numbers, when you're going to subtract them, your result should be 2. Then those are called twin prime numbers. Now the next is perfect numbers. Perfect number means when you're going to find out the factor of the given number and sum them and add the given number, then your answer should be same. Example, if I'm having 6, then what are the factors of 6? 1, 2, 3, then 6. So these are the factor of 6. When you're going to add it, so 2 plus 1 will be 3, 3 plus 3 will be 6, 6 plus 6 will be 12. And twice is, so this is the natural number whose sum is this factor is twice the number. Okay? So twice of the number means twice of the number 6. So sum of the factor is twice of number 6. So 12 is our sum, which is twice of this number 6. So it means these are the perfect number. 6 is the perfect number. Or you can take the example of 28 also. 28 is also a perfect number. So what are the factors of 28? 1 is the factor of 28. 2 is the factor of 28. Then 4 is the factor of 28. Then 7. Then 14. So these are the factor of 28 and 28. So when you're going to add it, you get the 56, which is twice of this number. So 28 is also a perfect number. Now the last one is prime triplet. A triplet of consecutive prime numbers differ by 2. Means when you're having 3 prime numbers and difference between each of them is 2, then that is called prime triplet. For example, if I am having 3, 5 and 7. So here difference is 2 and here difference is 2. So you can see that 3, 5, 7 is the prime triplet. We are only having one prime triplet and that is 3, 5 and 7. So that's for all. Please do it very clearly and learn all the definitions and all types of number.